Hi, I'm Maria Macsay, and I'm really excited to practice with you. We'll have a full body flow experience here in a moment, so get ready to move full out, standing postures, a fiery practice, and I'll see you in a moment. Welcome to today's practice, a full body practice. I'm really delighted to be here. Thank you, Cole. We are in Joshua Tree, as you can see, with the many Joshua trees behind me. And we'll draw inspiration from that, rising from the ground, rooting up, and being expressive through our limbs. So if you are enjoying this practice, remember that I will be sharing a live practice on CCY Studios next week, just in a couple of days, actually. And in the meantime, if you're enjoying this practice, hit like. If you are not yet subscribed to the channel, do that now, and then we'll head right into our practice. So go ahead and come into a child's pose. That's where we'll begin, getting close to the earth, grounding ourselves down. Take your knees wider than your hips. Sink your hips back towards your heels. Reach your arms out in front of you, if that's okay, on the top of your shoulders. And if you have any sensitivity in your shoulders today, just bend your elbows out to the side a little bit more. Let's arrive by letting go of the breath. Exhale out completely. Inhale. Sigh out through the mouth. Inhale through your nose. This time, seal your lips and exhale out through your nose. Take another couple of moments here to let your rib cage relax, hips melt towards your heels. And for today, just do the best that you can. Honor your body, listen to its sensations as we flow, as we expand, as we grow tall. On your next breath, and reach your arms out in front of you and pull yourself up to a tabletop position. Wrists underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips. And start to take a little bit of a C curve through the sides of your waist. So you'll wag your tail, if you will, side to side. And then think about meeting your ear towards your hip. So you're creating C curves, slowly wagging your tail. We saw some really cute dogs in town today, so I'm drawing inspiration from them. And then begin to move in any creative, juicy way that feels good to you. So it could be figure eights, it could be rolling your spine up and down in a barrel-like shape. Whatever way you're going, go the other way. Making space in your body. Beautiful. Left wrist stays rooted. Left hand stays rooted. Inhale to reach your right arm up, twist. And then exhale, thread your right arm underneath your left. We'll be here for one breath in. And the breath out. Inhale, press into your left hand. Reach your right arm up. Exhale, set the right hand down. Other side. Inhale, left arm up. Reach up. Exhale, thread your needle underneath your right arm. One breath in. One breath out. Inhale, press into your right arm. Reach your left arm up. Exhale, set the left hand down. Take one leg back, then the other leg back, high plank. Press into your finger pads. And make sure that your shoulders aren't in front of your fingers and not too far behind, but really stacked right over your wrists. Finger pads rooting down. Navel lifting up towards your spine. Crown of your head reaching forward. Heels of your feet reaching back. One more breath. And then exhale. Float your hips high. Downward facing dog. You can wiggle here. Again, wagging your tail. Bend your knees as much as you need. And cycle your breath in and out of your lungs in a steady state. Eventually come into stillness.
And you might want to bend your knees here so you can build stability through your hands, your shoulders to begin, and then we'll lengthen through the legs when you're ready. So press into your fingers, press down into your thumb and pointer finger a little bit more, and then scoop your armpits in towards your ears slightly. Set the shoulder blades onto the backs of your ribs. Drop your head. And now imagine someone's lifting your hips up and back at a diagonal. And if you feel that there's space in the backs of your legs, you can begin to extend your knees. On your next breath in, float high onto your toes forward into a high plank. And as you exhale, set your knees down, arch your back, chest down, chin down, look forward. Inhale, straighten your legs, point your toes to lift your heart into a baby cobra. And then exhale, lower yourself down, push back through child's pose if you like, and then meet in downward facing dog. On your next breath in, right leg up and back. As you exhale, curl the knee towards your chest and step forward into a runner's lunge. As you inhale, set your back heel down, cartwheel your arms up to warrior two stance. Let's just take a moment here, adjust. If you need to adjust the back foot, front heel cuts down into back arch, and then reach your arms out to the side. From warrior two in your legs, take your right arm over your left elbow, and then cross at your arms for eagle. You might just stay here and hug yourself. As you inhale, reach the hands up, straighten your front leg, front knee. Exhale, pull your elbows down, bend into your front knee. Now just peek down, make sure you can see your big toe. Inhale, reach up, straighten right leg. Exhale, elbows down, track your knee towards your second toe. One more time, inhale up, exhale down. Inhale, release your arms down, warrior two, look forward. As you exhale, right elbow to right thigh, left arm, swing it overhead. Take a breath in your side angle. And exhale, stay, really press your feet down into the mat. Inhale, sweep back, reverse your triangle. Reach up through your right fingertips as you press into your feet. Exhale, cartwheel your arms down. Step back, high plank. Inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, knees down, arch your back, chest down, chin down. Inhale, Bhujangasana, lift your heart. Exhale, press back, downward facing dog. Breath in steady. Breath out. Inhale to lift your left leg up and back. Exhale, curl your knee towards your chest and then quietly step your left foot forward. Inhale, sweep your arms up and overhead to arrive in warrior two. And then take a moment to adjust your legs. So front heel, back arch. I'm gonna flip around. You stay with your left leg forward just so we can see each other. And now take your arms out to the side. Left, I just confused myself. You're gonna take left arm over right elbow and then cross eagle arms. Does that happen to you ever? Okay, here we go. Straighten your front leg, lift your arms up. Exhale down. Inhale, arms up, left leg straightens as you exhale. Just peek down, make sure your knee's tracking over your second toe. Inhale to reach up. Exhale, come down. As you inhale, expand your arms, warrior two, look forward for a moment. Exhale, left forearm to left thigh, sweep right arm overhead. Create space along your rib cage as you breathe in. Exhale, press down into your feet, strong legs. Inhale, sweep up and back, straighten your front leg to reverse your triangle. And then exhale, cartwheel your arms down, step back, high plank. Inhale here, exhale, downward facing dog. Settle in. Again, this feeling of your finger pads down, thumb, pointer finger rooted, armpits scooping in, hips high. Let your head be heavy. Find a moment where there's complete stillness in your body.
Inhale, reach your right leg up and back. Exhale, step your foot between your hands. Back knee down. As you inhale, reach both of your arms up. Press your palms together, bend your elbows. Reverse prayer at the nape of your neck. As you breathe in, root your front heel down to lift your chest up and maybe back bend. Your back toes can be tucked like mine are, or you can have them untucked. Breathe into the sides of your lungs. One more breath. Inhale, send your hands forward. Tuck your back toes under if they're not there yet. Straighten your back leg and meet in downward facing dog. One more breath here. And breath out. Inhale, left leg up and back. Exhale, step your foot between your hands, back knee down. Rise up with your inhale. Exhale, palms together, reverse prayer at the nape of your neck. Point your elbows in and up. Breathe in. Exhale. Use your feet to press down on your inhale and then lift your heart high from that root. Rooting to rise. One more. If you're back bending, think up and over instead of crunching back. So up and over. Next breath in, hands towards your mat. Downward facing dog. Slowly here, descend with your knees onto the mat and come off to your feet. Good. We're going to go into a janushirasana, but variation off to the side. So you can bend your right knee in, left leg extended out to the side at a diagonal. Okay. And then we'll do a little side bending here to open up through the ribs some more. Left hand by your shin or onto your shin. Reach your left arm, rather your right arm overhead, side bend. So now sometimes what I like to do is take my opposite hand, my bottom hand, to the opposite thigh and just really press down. Yeah, remind your hips to stay even and anchored. And some of you, if you have the space, you might reach all the way up and over for your foot. I'm gonna stay up. That's it. Next breath in. Go ahead, set your right hand behind you and then press into this little variation of a stargazer. Hips forward, heart opens, gazing back, and then eventually coming down. Good, switch sides here. Take the opposite side, right leg out to the side, left leg in. Breathe to create length through the sides of your waist and then side bend towards your extended leg. If it helped to take that bottom hand to your opposite hip and really anchor it down, go ahead and do that again. Create ease around your shoulders as you reach here. Enjoy the space that you're creating around your waist, around your hips. And see if you can soften a little bit more. Let your heart expand in the shape. On your next breath in, come on up, set your left hand behind you. Press onto your front shin, back foot, heart forward, stargazer. Enjoying this delicious opening in the front of the heart. And then make your way back down. Cross-legged here. And taking a moment to twist. Arms up. Seat rooted. Twist towards the right. So when you're twisting, really imagine your spine on an axis. Down through your tailbone, up through the crown of your head. And then rotate around that center. Sometimes the front shoulder likes to go with your twist. Roll that shoulder back and allow your eyes to land wherever is most natural for you. As you inhale, come back to center. Arms up high. Exhale to twist. Once again, notice if you're leaning in any direction. Anchor yourself through the midline of your body. Keep your front shoulder rolling back, drawing back. Every inhale gives you the opportunity to fill yourself up and grow a little taller. And the exhale might invite you into a little bit more of a twist. Breathing in back to center. Exhale, hands down to your heart. Soften your eyes, closing your eyelids down. And drop your awareness into your abdomen and then all the way down into your hips. Flush any kind of holding or tension down through your body, through your tailbone. And then anchor yourself into the earth. Notice the tingles, the pulsation of energy from opening up through the lines of your body and activating through your central muscles. And as I said at the beginning, just do your best with this practice. A reminder that we humans are always doing the best that we can. People in our lives are doing the best that they can. And so let this practice inspire you to see that in others, see that in yourself. Find peace and satisfaction with what is here today. And thank you for practicing, for sharing your time, bowing down to our hearts, to our bodies, giving thanks for this practice and for our ability to be on the mat with each other. Namaste. Thank you for joining me in gorgeous Joshua Tree. And thank you again to Cole for having me. And we will see you very soon. Reminder that I'm teaching a live class on CCY Studios in just a couple of days. So plug into that and I will get to meet you live. Have a beautiful rest of your day and we'll see you for the next practice.